possible.
All right, so what was your reaction to what Jarvis Landry had to say?
It was great that he gave us a little bit of insight. Typically, people make excuses when they drop the ball, but you could see in the game. And it also speaks to NFL practices. The backups, they don't get a lot of reps with the starters. So, you know, Tyrod Taylor has been throwing to Jarvis Landry all through the OTAs, all through the mini camps, all through training camp, and the first 2.5 games of the regular season. So you could see initially in the game, the difference was the flight of the ball. When Baker throws the ball comes out flat compared to Tyrod, who puts a little more arc on it. And you can see on that shallow cross, because the ball, it surprised him because it hit him. His hands are too good. Last year, leading the NFL in receptions, the ball hits him on his back shoulder, so his eyes missed it. So the reason why you go on the jugs machine is get your eye acclimated, especially to the point of the football. When a guy throws the ball with a lot of velocity, the point is coming at you with a tighter spiral. Aaron Rodgers, it's almost like a little cross comes right at your eye. So you have to get your eyes used to seeing it. The jugs machine, I've worked with them for years. It is the best training tool for training people how to catch a football. And also the jugs, you can put the ball in there and the ball can come out wobbly. But the guy like Baker, you put it in there and it comes out a nice tight spiral that your eyes get all those reps that you need to get to be able to adjust to a guy who's going to flight the ball like Baker's going to be able to flight it, because he does have a strong arm.
Does velocity always make for a good quarterback or a successful quarterback, or do you need the variance of both? The velocity plus the accuracy plus that soft touch when you need it.
Very good question. It's just like pitching. Would you want a guy who can throw 105, but that's all he can throw? Major league batters eventually will catch up to it because it's on a straight line, and they'll be able to time up their bat, and they'll be able to groove a fastball eventually. Now, as a thrower, the reason why you don't want that is because if I'm throwing with velocity, I'm throwing the ball on a line. That's the only way you can create velocity. But what about those NFL linebackers and those defensive backs? So you need the variance sometimes to be able to ride it up and to be able to bring it down. Sometimes you do need a heater. Is it impossible to play without one? No, it's not impossible. But if you start with talent, I want the variance. I want a guy who is a quarterback of the football compared to a guy who's just a thrower. That's the difference between Josh Rosen. That's the difference between Sam Darnold. That's the difference between Baker Mayfield, and difference between them and Lamar Jackson, and them and Josh Allen.
Who's all right? That what? Josh
those
Allen
first
and Lamar
three,
are
those are all
those.
Quarterbacks. The other guys, Lamar, he's a thrower of the football. Josh Allen, he has the big arm, which you talked about, and he is not. He doesn't have that variance yet in his career.
Josh Allen right now has got one speed.
Yeah.
It's a fastball every time.
Yes. Lamar's better than him, but he's just a different version.
And Lamar doesn't have what Allen has in the overall arm strength. Lamar's going to need his entire body in order to be able to throw it maybe 80% as far as Josh Allen can. But what is the reason that I'm so bullish on Baker Mayfield despite the size and despite what we thought were maybe limitations coming out of Oklahoma is we have now seen that he does have the strong arm, but we knew from college he must have elite accuracy. You
yeah.
don't have the efficiency mm-hmm. all-time, first and second place all-time in college football. Efficiency is Baker Mayfield's last
year.
Could
have came out after his junior year
yep.
and been a high draft pick, decided I want to get better going back to college. And we saw this with Sam Darnold. He didn't get better going back for that extra year. Josh Rosen, he didn't get better. The only one who really got better out of all the quarterbacks who were drafted in the first round was Baker, Nick.
Right. Josh Allen actually probably took a step backwards from one year to the next. So that's why, and I thought that Jarvis Landry talking about that play was so interesting, because it was exactly what Friday on the show we talked about, and he confirmed it, that he was used to catching call it a changeup from Jarvis Landry,
yeah.
and a heater came in on him, because that was a perfect, it hit him in the number. It was a perfect pass, and it wasn't even a drop in the way that it hit his hands. His hands didn't get there. Sometimes you make a drop because you have your hands ready, but you look upfield, right?
Yeah.
You're trying to move before you get the ball. He just didn't think the ball was going to be there when it got there, and so it hit his shoulder pad or hit his chest plate before he could even get his hands up, which that is not who Jarvis Landry is. Like, you don't lead the NFL in catches if that happens to you. It was just, we found out this past week, the Browns, They gave Baker zero first-team reps in practice, in training camp, or in the week leading up to the game. Jarvis didn't play in second team, so he hadn't had a lot of experience catching the ball from him.
Give people just an idea of who Baker Mayfield reminds you of with that perfect combination of speed and accuracy. Who's currently playing or is doing it really, really well at that high level that you like, that he could grow into?
This is the thing. He's a combination between the guys who are height challenged. He's a combination between Russell Wilson and Drew Brees. Drew Brees has accomplished so much. I don't even want to put him in the same breath. But, man, he has the same type of talent that if one day we're talking about him with those quarterbacks, I wouldn't be so surprised at all.
All right, one more break coming up. Can the Vikings slow down the Rams on Thursday Night Football next on First Things First?
Vikings. That's the Vikings ball right here. Oh, that's good luck right there. Nick said put some money on that. That's good luck.
Oh, yeah. I do like the Vikings tonight.
And you like money.
Plus seven? I like it. You can't talk about it.